This short tutorial will explain how to insert a best fit regression into an Excel XY scatter graph. To illustrate, we will begin with the graph created in the previous tutorial. In order to simplify the example, we will only work with one of the dependent variables, 3PGA. I will remove the information for Rubisco. So selecting the chart, under the Design tab, using the Select Data option, we'll list the series that are presently included in the chart. I'll highlight Rubisco and click the Remove key. And now the Rubisco means and lines have been removed from our plot. In Excel, with only one series included in a chart, it duplicates the legend as a title. I'll get rid of the title by clicking on it and pressing the delete key. It's not needed in your figure because your figure will have a full caption, and having that extra title reduces the area available for the scatter plot. Don't make the mistake of connecting the symbols with a smooth line. I will illustrate why this is not correct. Smooth lines can be created by formatting the series and by altering the line style. There's a small little box here. Click on Smooth Lines, and it converts the connecting lines to a smooth line. A smooth line is an artistic technique of connecting the symbols with curved lines. The pattern produced is not the best fit regression line and does not properly represent the change over the levels of the independent variable. This particular example implies that the peak of the response will be around 31 Celsius. Do not graph scientific data using smooth lines. Always plot the correct best fit regression response. If you don't have a regression line, connect with straight lines. Since we are going to plot the best fit regression response, I will remove the connecting lines between the symbols. Select the series, format the series, go to Line Color and choose No Line. Click on Close, and now we've converted the plot to a simple scatter graph of the means with their standard errors. Excel has some built-in options for plotting trend lines. Note that these regressions are computed using type 1 methods. Unless you are dealing with a very simple relationship, these trend lines may not be the most appropriate best fit regression. To illustrate, you can access the built-in trend lines by selecting the series, under the Layout tab, Trend Line, More Options. The default is a linear regression. It does not adequately explain the response over this temperature phase. And that is also the case with the various other possible trend line versions that are default in the package. If I go to the polynomial and fit a higher order, I can obtain a line that goes through each of the points. But that gives a response that does not make biological sense. With that equation, as we increase temperature to high levels, the rate of reduction is decreasing and levels off. We know that is not the case. I'll reverse back and get rid of the trend line. For this type of response, we would prefer to fit a logistic regression in which the model begins with a plateau and then a decline. Or perhaps a two-phase segmented regression in which on the left side, the response increases to a critical value and then decreases. With a segmented regression, the response patterns can be quite different on either side of the critical point. One can also model a three-phase or four-phase response, depending on the relationship. To determine the correct regression form, one would conduct a variance analysis using a linear or nonlinear model to determine significance and the best fit equation. You would use a program such as SAS, the Statistical Analysis System, to perform these analyses. Once the best fit model is identified based on F-tests and residual plots, predicted values over the range of the study can then be computed. The predicted values and the equation can be inserted into the Excel spreadsheet and the best fit regression line plotted. For this example, I performed an analysis in SAS using a segmented linear model with two linear equations. On the left side of a critical point, as temperature increases, so does the production of 3 PGA. After the critical point, the production declines. The segmented model was structured that the two equations would join at a common point, which would be the critical temperature at which the response changes. Here is a summary of the analysis. The variable J is the estimated temperature at which the response changes. 31.96 Celsius with a standard error of 1.6. At lower temperatures, 3 PGA was increasing at the rate of 0.5 micromoles per degree increase in temperature. And above the critical temperature, it decreased at the rate of 36 micromoles for every degree increase in temperature. Using the best fit segmented equations, I obtained predicted values for temperature increments of 0.1 degrees. I then copied the predicted values from my SAS analysis into the Excel spreadsheet. We can now add the predicted values as another series in the chart. I will call this series predicted. I will also include the R square from the regression analysis. In this analysis, it is 0.99. I'll now enter the values for the independent variable, which is temperature. And the values for the dependent variable, which in this case are the predicted values at each temperature. Click OK. And now it has been added as a series to my chart. I will also revise the name of the first series to clarify that the symbols are mean of observed values. And I'll click OK, and the chart is now updated with our additional series. I'll need to change the format of the predicted series. I will have it plotted with no markers, and I'll also reduce the line width. Adding a line and changing the style to perhaps 1.5. If you had another series of means, you would repeat this process to include the best fit prediction for that particular variable. I could also add in other features, such as the critical value of the response, which in this example was 31.9 Celsius. I could also add the equations, which describe the response. Note that there is a wide error range with the mean estimate in this region. To improve the estimate of the critical value, one would want to repeat this study, but focus on additional temperature treatments in this range, perhaps including temperatures such as 31 and 33 would improve the estimate of the critical temperature in this region. This concludes our series on creating bar charts and XY scatterplots in Excel.